Dom's turning on you right now, Steven.
I'm not a yo-yo. I don't sit here begging.
He came right over. Here he is, ladies and gentlemen. The great Stephen A. Smith joins us.
Michael K.
It is so sad. Somebody becomes a megastar, and you just, yes. I mean, you blow us off. It's sad. First of all,
tell me how I blew you off. I don't understand.
Peter was telling us you will be here at 4 o'clock.
Excuse me. 4:19. Excuse me, I just walked in the building. When I walked in the building, I had no knowledge whatsoever. To my understanding, I was supposed to be doing 2 interviews and then come to you, and Peter was calling for me now, and I said, whoa, that's Michael K. And I was sat right down.
He really did. He did.
And so how could you say such things? You know why?
Because I turn on the Oscars and you're there. I turn on the debate post-game show on CNN. You should have been there.
No. You know what? I got to admit to you, Mike. I've actually thought about running for president. I really have. I mean, I don't have enough knowledge of the policies. I recognize that. But damn it, some would argue neither does most of the people running for president, or even somebody in office. I don't know. I'm just saying. Could you imagine?
I would vote for you if
I was a presidential candidate and I was on a Michael K. show. Could you imagine what that would be like?
It would be incredible.
Talking about the issues. Now, can you imagine that?
Now, Stephen, you do seem to have a special bounce in your step. Right. I know you've said this many times.
Yeah.
You love all sports.
Yeah.
But nothing gets you going like a big heavyweight championship fight.
Boxing and basketball, but boxing. I was watching boxing since I was 3 years old. My father, God rest his soul, was a huge, huge boxing and baseball fan. And, you know, he always had me. He loved Ali. I remember when he was crying. He was literally crying before the Ali-Foreman fight. He thought Ali was going to die. He thought Ali was going to die, and he loved Muhammad Ali so much. And I've been watching it since I was 3 years old. So I love a big fight again when basketball, the aficionado status comes in because of all the people that I know covering the sport and are involved in the sport. The other sports, I'm a spectator, a journalist. You watch, and, you know, you watch and talk about the event you actually witness, as opposed to guys like Max and others who are studying fighters that's ranked 50th. And I don't know those people. I only know the top-notch dudes, okay? These two are the top-notch dudes in terms of Wilder and Fury, and it's a boxer versus a puncher because Deontay Wilder is not a boxer, but he's got a nuclear right hand. I call him the Tommy Hitman Hearns of the heavyweight division. He can't box as well as Tommy Hitman Hearns could box, but boy, that right hand is something lethal, and he's one of those guys that he doesn't even try. He just sits back and waits to be able to throw the right hand at you. Everything is to try and set up the right, and obviously, 95.3% of the time, he's caught you with it. That's Deontay Wilder.
Isn't it interesting, though, Stephen, that in the previous fight that they had, he hit Fury, and I just spoke about this earlier, with two of the hardest punches ever, and Fury did not stay down. That bodes well for him, especially if he could last the whole fight. He could win on points.
I have a slightly different version of that. I think the right he caught it with, but it wasn't to the jaw. It was like the top of the top left side of his head, right? So he was going down, and then when he hit him with the left hook, everybody acts like he caught him flush with like the left hook, but it was like the side of his fist. It wasn't his pure fist connecting with the left that really, really dropped him. That's number one. Number two, Fury is 250 pounds, and even though he went down, you got to remember, he keeps telling his story, and we got to listen to him. He's been to hell and back. So it's like, excuse me, unless I'm completely out of it, you know, you're going to have to put me to sleep or kill me to keep me down, because I've been to hell and back, and I know what it is,
now,
and I'll get up.
I've been quoting you for the last couple of months. When I did that boxing show a while, and you called in.
Sure.
You said, I asked you about Joshua, and you said, stop worrying about Joshua. Right. This is the fight.
Right.
Michael asked a question earlier that I thought was really great. Mm-hmm. Who's Anthony Joshua rooting for tomorrow night?
Well, Anthony Joshua should be rooting. He should be rooting for Tyson Fury. And the reason why he should be rooting for Tyson Fury is because Tyson Fury is the better boxer, but not the puncher. If you look at Anthony Joshua is actually a really good boxer. His issue is he has a highly questionable jaw.
100%.
He got dropped by Klitschko. He got knocked out by Andy Ruiz.
Yep.
Got dropped about 4 or 5 times after dropping him in that third round. And listen, Andy Ruiz can fight. He's got speed. He's got power. Plus, he can box. But damn it, a dude with Anthony Joshua's body shouldn't be getting knocked out by a dude that looked like Jabba the Hutt. It just shouldn't happen. And that's exactly what happened. And so for me, I can't recall that time in a long time where I've been so angry at a fighter, because I was salivating over Joshua versus Wilder. And when I saw Joshua go down like that, I said, damn, there goes the mega fight. Now it's just another good fight if they fight, as opposed to the mega fight with suspense, wondering what's going to happen. We all know it's just a matter of if Wilder catches Joshua because of what we saw happen to Joshua, and that's what depressed me.
Now Aram said this is the biggest fight since Ollie Frazier. That's obviously hyperbole, but for
yes,
you, what's this is the biggest fight since when?
It's hard to say, Don. I would tell you that it's a big fight for the heavyweight division. But when we think about, I mean, to me, Canelo versus Triple G was a bigger fight. That was a bigger fight than this. This is a big fight, don't get me wrong. Tyson Holyfield, that was a bigger fight, you know. Lennox Lewis Holyfield, that was a bigger fight. Riddick Bowe versus Holyfield, that was a bigger fight. I'm sorry, I don't view this on that level. It's a big fight. No question, but when you look at Tyson Fury and you look at the, and I don't want to call them no names like they don't deserve any respect, because obviously all fighters do this at least to a large degree. I just don't know most of these guys other than Klitschko, which is one of the most boring fights that I've ever seen when Fury beat him.
Well, yeah, I never, after that fight, I didn't think Fury was even good.
There you go.
I thought Fury was the next John Ruiz.
There you go. And so
and it turned out to be a stud.
We saw him against Wilder, and we say, okay, give him his respect. But that's what you see, and that's all you see. So it's a big fight. It matters. But let's put it in perspective. The reason why it really is such a big fight is because we're finally getting to see a big heavyweight fight, because we don't see too many of these.
So who are you picking?
I'm picking Wilder in 8.
Oh, same pick.
Wilder in 8.
That's
I think Wilder is going to get thoroughly outboxed. Thoroughly, not hurt, but thoroughly outboxed in 6 of the first 7 rounds. And it's all about him waiting to catch Fury. I think Fury's going to get cocky. I think he's going to get loose. And you know what I'm comparing
start
it to?
His games.
You know what I'm going to compare it to? Do y'all remember years ago Larry Holmes, the great Larry Holmes, all right, with that great right hand and one of the greatest jabs we've ever seen in the history of boxing? Remember Larry Holmes comes out of retirement to fight Mike Tyson?
Oh,
I sure do. This is Mike Tyson, right? Before he ended up going to prison, right? He fights Mike Tyson, and literally, this old man with a pot belly is outclassing Mike Tyson for the first 3 rounds. And then the next thing you know, he starts jumping around and dancing and throwing his jab. And Mike Tyson, whoop, overhand right, catches him. Holmes goes down, gets up, goes down again, gets up, gets hit by Tyson because his arm gets cut in the rope and he can't protect himself. And Tyson catches him with a hook. It's over. The thing that I remember about that fight is that Larry Holmes got comfortable and cocky. Who's the one boxer that you'll see jumping around doing that in the heavyweight division?
Tyson Fury. He loves to dance.
And I think that he's going to dance. He's going to box. He's going to get an edge over Wilder. He's going to get comfortable, and Wilder's going to clip him. I'm predicting it will happen in the 8th round, and he will not get up this time around. It's going to be a KO.
Now, I'm wondering, Stephen, you like Wilder in the 8th round. Will you go to the windows and invest some of your institutional wealth on this fight?
Well, first of all, Michael K, I can make a legitimate argument that Michael K is getting paid more than me.
I can make that argument.
No, you can't.
The New York Post says otherwise.
We have no proof of anything otherwise. I mean, the multiple jobs that you have, the voice of the New York Yankees, arguably the greatest sports franchise in the history of sports.
True.
Okay, you're doing that. You got a top-notch, big-time, drive-time radio show. Okay.
Let's whip out our W-2s.
Well, you know what? Let me be Bloomberg and Trump and all of those. I'm sorry, I don't have my records right now. I'll try to get them to you in a matter of months. We'll figure that out and I'll get it to you, and we'll talk about it then.
You know what worries me the most, Stephen A? This worries me. Because you know I love you, okay?
Yeah, man.
So, heavyweight, we were just talking about it with Peter. Heavyweight title fights, I mean, there are a lot of temptations for you, Stephen A. I don't want you getting in trouble this weekend.
That's a good point.
Yeah, that is true. You know, I mean, it is It can be tough. It can be tough. But I didn't get to where I'm at in this profession by lacking discipline.
That's right.
And keeping myself zero focus on the task at hand. Although I'm going to tell you this much. I'll confess this to you over the national airwaves, Michael K. The one time that I was in trouble, I was on this show. You were interviewing me. Do you remember when you and Juan and Don Juan was interviewing me? When I was standing on Biscayne Bay in Miami.
Not that,
because while y'all were talking to me, they were just walking by and they were like, hi, Stephen A. And I was like, I'm trying to do the radio show, but I'll be right there, but I've got to do the radio show right now.
We appreciate that.
I will admit it. I had to be laser focused.
Laser focused.
If I could deal with the Michael K. Show under those conditions
on Biscayne Bay,
I can handle the strip.
But you know what's scary though, Peter. This is what's scary. So that was many years ago.
Many. Yes.
Now we're talking institutional wealth.
No, he's a megastar. He's the biggest star in television. He's literally one of the biggest stars in television.
And he's also innately good looking too.
It's easy. Well, thank you so much. I appreciate that, Michael K. I appreciate that. But see, here's where it's easier. Because I got a little bit going on, I'm protective.
That's right.
I mean, I'm worried because why is she coming at me?
Right.
What's her intent? What's her motivation? You know what I'm saying? I got to look at all of these things. You see what I'm saying? Before, I was like, hey. Now it's like, no. You know, you could be trying to set me up. I don't know what you're trying to do.
I like the way you think.
I'm sorry. And not only that, I insulate myself with great, great friends like all of you guys. So I got people watching my back constantly, and I'm good.
When I compare the wealth of you two, Peter, I think you'll appreciate this. I think Michael can tell the temperature of the water. I think Stephen can tell you how deep it is.
And what about you, Don Juan? You ain't living bad. I see the slick back hair, the Pat Riley look. The cigars from Cuba. I see all of that, Don Juan. I mean, you ain't innocent and broken all of this picture. Come on now.
We love you for dropping by. Enjoy the weekend.
I love y'all. You know that, man. Appreciate it anytime, fellas. You know that.
All right. You got it. That's the great Stephen A. Smith.
Right.
First
Thanks,
take.
Thanks.
He's on all the portals. He has the Wednesday Sports Center. You can watch him there.